pop. Six. Squish. Uh-oh. Cicero. Clip shit. Now, the six merry murderesses of the Cook County Jail and their rendition of the Cell Block Tango. Lipschitz. Hop. Six. Squish. Cicero. Lipschitz. Hop. Six. Squish! Cicero! Lipschitz! Pop! Six! Squish! Cicero! Lipschitz! Pop! Six! Squish! Cicero! Lipschitz! He had it coming! He had it coming! He only had himself to blame! If you have been there, if you have seen it, I bet sure you would have done the same! You know how people have these little habits that get you down. Like Bernie. Bernie liked to chew gum. No, not chew. Pop. So I came home this one day, and I'm like looking for pity, a little bit of sympathy. There's Bernie lying on the couch, drinking a beer and chewing. No, not chewing. Popping. So I said to him, you pop that gum one more time. And he did. So I took the shotgun and fired two warning shots into his head. He had it coming. He had it coming. He only had himself to blame. If you have been there, if you have heard it, I bet sure you would have done the same. I met Ezekiel Young from Salty Lily about 2 years ago, and he told me he was single, and we hit it off right away. So we started living together. He'd go to work, he'd come home, I'd fix him a drink, we'd have dinner, and then I found out. Single, he told me. Single my ass. No, not only was he married, oh no, he had six wives. One of those Mormons. So that night when he came home from work, I fixed him his usual drink. You know, some guys just can't hold their arsenic. He had it coming, pop, six, push, and roll. He had it coming all along. And then he used it, and he abused it. It was a murder, but not a crime. Now I'm standing in the kitchen, carving up my chicken for dinner, minding my own business. In storms my husband Wilbur in jealous rage. You've been screwing the milkman, he says. He was crazy, and he kept on screaming, you've been screwing the milkman. And he ran into my knife. He ran into my knife 10 times. If you've been there, if you have seen it, I bet sure you would have done the same. Yeah, but did he do it? No! Not guilty! My sister Veronica and I had a double act, and my husband Charlie traveled around with us. Now, for the last number, we did 20 acrobatic tricks in a row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Split, spread eagles, back legs, flip flops. One right after the other. One night before the show, we're down at the Hotel Cicero. The three of us boozing and having a few laughs. We run out of ice, so I go out and get some. I come back, open the door, and there's Veronica and Charlie doing number 17. The spread eagle. Well, I was in such a state of shock. I completely backed out. I can't remember a thing. It wasn't until later when I was washing the blood out of my hands. I even knew they were dead. They had it coming. They had it coming. They had it coming all along. I didn't do it. But if I do it, how could you tell me that I was wrong? They had it coming. They had it coming. They had it coming all along. Tell me that I was wrong. I love Upshits and all possibly say. He was a real artistic guy, sensitive, a painter. But he was always trying to find himself. He'd go out every night looking for himself, and on the way, he found Ruth, Gladys, Rosemary, and Irving. You could say we broke up because of artistic differences. He saw himself as alive, and I saw him as dead.
The dirty bum 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 bum. The dirty bum bum bum.
They had it coming. They had it coming. They had it coming all along. They abuse us and they abuse us. Could you tell us that we were wrong? He had it coming. He had it coming. He only had himself to blame. If you have missed it, if you have seen it, I bet you would have done the same. Pop that gum one more time. Sangle my ass 10 times.
Number 17, spread eagle.
Artistic differences. Pop, sis, squish, scissor, lip shit.